North Korea. With its back turned to the rest of the world, the reclusive state is focused mainly on its bargaining chip, its weapons program. In terms of missile development, it's been pushing ahead at a faster speed than ever before. Their latest test launch proved the regime's nearing a level where it can strike the U.S. mainland with nuclear-tipped ICBM. In our news features tonight, Oh Jung-hee illustrates how far the Hermit Kingdom has come in nuclear warhead miniaturization and missile atmospheric re-entry technology.
북한이 ICBM 그 탄도 미사일을 완성하고 거기에 핵탄두를 탑재해서 무기화 하게 되는 것을 레드라인이라고 생각합니다. 지금 북한이 점점 그 레드라인의 임계치에 다가가고 있다고 생각합니다.
During the decades-old tug-of-war with North Korea, the general understanding of North Korea crossing the line has been the regime being able to strike the continental United States with a nuclear-tipped ICBM. How one arrives at that assessment is complicated, but the North's second ICBM test in late July did suggest that it might be possible.
North Korea has shown us that its missile can fly up to 7,000 or 8,000 kilometers if launched on a flatter trajectory that can reach the western coast of America. Pyongyang's final destination is Washington, the center of the U.S. mainland.
To make that happen, there are two crucial technologies Pyongyang needs to develop. First, having a light enough nuclear warhead or strong enough engine to reach long-distance targets. And second, having the missile successfully re-enter the atmosphere. How far has North Korea come in these two technologies, and what's the international community's assessment? To increase the missile's airborne distance, the nuclear warhead has to be as small and light as possible. According to the U.S.-based Washington Post, a confidential U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency analysis early this month suggested that Pyongyang has produced a miniaturized nuclear warhead. Japan's defense white paper also wrote, the North may have miniaturized nuclear warheads. The ideal weight of a nuclear warhead designed for an ICBM is generally seen to be around the 500-kilogram range. But even if the warhead isn't at the ideal weight, experts say if the engine's strong enough, Pyongyang's missile can reach long-distance targets.
If the North can fire its missile to the U.S. with its current engine, that means the North has lightened its warhead enough. I've conducted a virtual simulation after the recent launches. The North's missile can carry a 700-kilogram nuclear warhead to the U.S. with the engine it has now.
The North's ICBM may be able to fly far enough, but it seems the regime hasn't completed missile re-entry technology as of yet. An ICBM usually flies 1,000 to 1,500 kilometers off the ground, and when it re-enters the atmosphere, it falls at a speed of 30,000 kilometers per hour. The missile has to endure frictional heat of 7,000 to 8,000 degrees Celsius, as well as massive pressure and vibrations, to protect the nuclear bomb inside for successful detonation.
The missile's nose cone has to be thoroughly designed to ensure 50 times the usual gravitational force. And no matter how much you develop a rocket engine, it can't be perfect because it can fail so easily with only the smallest of errors. Also, it's very rare to put the technology into real use after a few tests.
In order to fall into nearby waters, the North's Hwasong 14s were launched at a steep trajectory to reach 2,800 and 3,700 kilometers off the ground during July's tests, much higher than usual ICBMs. Many say that is the reason why the North's missile launch failed to demonstrate successful atmospheric re-entry. The U.S. Central Intelligence Agency assesses that North Korea's ICBM re-entry vehicles may perform adequately if flown on a normal trajectory, but skepticism still remains.
They haven't demonstrated that they have anywhere near a reliable launch capability for an ICBM or even an intermediate-range ballistic missile that could target Guam. What I would expect is they'd want to do several more tests that would involve a long distance and a re-entry vehicle coming back in. Because in the end, the technology or the engineering of re-entry vehicles is very much a hands-on development. I mean, theory can work to a certain point, but you really just have to do it over and over again and see what works and doesn't work. And
a photo released by North Korea state media on Wednesday hints that the reclusive regime is on its way to developing another three-stage ICBM, Hwasong-13, which can fly even farther than the Hwasong-14 missiles launched in July. It seems there's not much time left until Pyongyang completes its desired level of nuclear and missile power, with experts expecting the re-entry technology to be completed within the next few years. Woo Jung-hee, Arirang News.